All right, everybody, it is Monday, November 1st, 2010, and this is your Daily Dose. I apologize that I haven't been able to do as many videos. Like I said, I've been told to kind of stay quiet, you know, during this whole process, so on and so forth. But I had to do a video tonight because we got to talk about voting. So if you're going to vote, good for you. If you're not going to vote, don't complain about when things ain't right and things are wrong or whatever. This is your chance to do something about it. If you think your vote is worthless, then you're absolutely right. Your vote is worthless. But if you educate yourself and you know what it is you're voting about, then it doesn't matter what you vote for because it's what you vote for. And if that's what you believe in and that's what you're voting for, you're never wasting your vote. So remember that. Also, let me show y'all this dope shirt in case y'all haven't seen it before. Oh, snap. But anyway, have y'all ever seen one of these things? It's a remote. Was that not the business? I mean, I can turn fans on, all kinds of stuff, all kinds of craziness. All right, back to the point here. This voting thing. Not every, you'll see I have mine marked out like a good scorekeeper would. Got some notes that I've been making, you know, because I like to be an informed voter. And right now I'm just going to tell you about if you remember a few months back, way back when Craig was still working and volunteering with us, he had sent out a bunch of emails to all these candidates for the primaries. And we got some responses, so on and so forth. And well, we told people we would hold them accountable for those emails. And what, they thought we were kidding? So I'm going to let you guys know exactly what we found out, for which races we found out. For most of them, you're going to find out that none of these candidates is probably your best choice. But of all the things we get to choose from, and these are just for the general election. This has nothing to do with the nonpartisan offices yet. And the first one says for United States Senate, which is a six-year term. And this is the one where everybody's talking about Angle, Reed. Well, of all the candidates that we spoke with, there's only one, believe it or not, that sent a full, thorough, yes, you should have safe access. Yes, the Constitution needs to be enforced. Basically, everything that I would want as a medical marijuana patient, this person stated in their correspondence to us through their camp and in person. And that was the independent representative by the name of Jesse Holland. So vote for who you want. I'm just letting you know that of all the people that responded, we did not get any response from the Reed or Angle camp. But we got a response from the Holland camp, the Fasano camp, the Ashgen camp. All those camps responded. Boom. Holland, Jesse Holland, had the best stance. Now, who will I be voting for? Well, I'm not political, but as a private citizen, when I go to vote tomorrow, well, as far as my U.S. Senate vote, I can tell you this. I'm not voting for Harry Reid. I'm not voting for Sharon Angle. But that none of these candidates looks really good. But then again, Jesse Holland seems like he has what's very important to me in mind. So we'll see how it goes. Then for the representative in District 1, of course, everybody knows that Shelley Berkeley has been supportive of the medical cannabis community. So, but as far as the responses go, the next thing I want to go out of my way to talk about, governor. And I can tell you this right now, out of all of the candidates here, the only two that sent favorable responses were David Scott Curtis of the Green Party and Arthur Lampett Jr. of the Libertarian Party. And two people that sent their opinions in where I'd have to put serious question marks next to them would be Eugene DeSimone and Floyd Fitzgibbons. Those two names seem very... The research I was able to turn up, but right now, as far as where I'm leaning, once again, probably Lampett, but people will say, oh, yeah, whatever. Hey, do your research, vote for what you want to vote for. My vote, I'm going to use it. And right now, as far as the things that concern me, Lampett is probably the best choice in my opinion. Now, next thing we want to talk about. Attorney General. Now, people will have seen the commercial, Travis Barrett, criminal, but I can tell you this right now. Catherine Cortez Masto, worthless. That's all I can tell you. No help to medical marijuana patients. We can't have an attorney general like that. Especially with the slew of court cases that will probably be popping off in Nevada very shortly, as you'll find out. Now, the next thing we want to talk about, district attorney, David Roger, Don Charette. Well, I can tell you this right now. David Roger will not be getting my vote. Enough said there. Now, people will ask about this next one because they'll be like, well, what the hell would a county assessor have anything to do? Look, you never know what positions affect anywhere, but like I've said before, if you get a paycheck from the state of Nevada, I want to know what you think because I'm paying you. And in my opinion, if my money ends up going to pay you, then I kind of feel the rights to know what you think and feel while you're doing your job. So with that being said, as far as county assessor goes, and you're trying to wonder whose name and there's liberty, blah, blah, blah. Well, Michelle Schaefer, I hope I say that correctly. Basically, she was the only person that responded and was personal enough to share her feelings and thoughts about cannabis and so on and so forth. Now, keep in mind, just because these people shared their thoughts about cannabis doesn't mean it was favorable. Sometimes a candidate's honest response about saying something like, well, I don't believe in legalizing it. I believe medical is okay. I believe that our system is flawed, but I don't see a way to fix it, so I wouldn't do it right away. If somebody was honest, boom, they get respect in my book. Doesn't mean they get my vote, but they get respect. And that's why we're letting people know, because Michelle Schaefer, she has my respect. Now, I don't want you to think that she didn't support, but at the same time, I don't want you to think that she did. So just know that she was the one candidate that at least sent her thoughts and feelings on the subject. Now, the next county recorder, people are thinking, what the heck with their thoughts on medical cannabis? You're right. But once again, I like to know. So we sent everybody the email and we did not get any responses except for one. And it was one of those of indifference. And I can tell you right now, Debbie Conway is going to miss out on quite a few votes because of the indifference that she showed about saying that it wasn't her job. So why should she have an answer for that? Well, because as constituents, we like to hear answers for things. So just so you know, out of nobody responded except for Debbie Conway. And she responded that, well, she really didn't need to respond. So she shouldn't have responded at all. Would have gotten her further. Now, like I said, other offices, blah, 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 blah. The one thing I will jump to where it says nonpartisan offices, the most important one on the ballot to me, sheriff. And I can promise you right now that Sheriff Doug Gillespie will not be getting my vote tomorrow. You saw the letters to my landlord. You see the activities, the bullying, the terrorism taking place against. There is no way that I will let this happen to more citizens. And it's Douglas C. Gillespie that's ultimately responsible and has been responsible during his last term. So, like my one friend said, if they're already in office, vote them out because nothing's going to change. The same things are going to keep happening in Nevada if the same people have offices. So, with that being said, those are all the elected things. When it comes to district court judges and things like that nature, I honestly will admit I didn't take as much time to research them. I only stuck to, like, you know, the justice of the Supreme Court, the district court. As far as family court and things like that, I didn't really look them over. But we have that. Now, we have some general election ballot questions. And with those, you know, should the Nevada Constitution be amended? No, it shouldn't. To change the way we appoint judges? No. No. Shall the Nevada Constitution for the establishment of an appellate court? One more step? Courts are already long enough as it is. People have already told me that I'm looking at a 7 to 10 year process possibly. Yeah, I want one more appellate court? No, thank you. Amendment to the sales tax? Well, if it's been good to go since 1955, why change it now? Only way they'd want to change it if there's something that they want to fish with that the average person in public probably wouldn't care about, but it would make a big deal as far as overall fiscal budgets for communities go. No way. Then it says another amendment about the way I look at it. Look, it doesn't matter. No, across the board. No, 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 no. And that's how we feel about all the ballot questions. So we've talked about the people. I'm going to tell you who I am voting for. Make it simple. I'm voting for Jesse Holland for U.S. Senate. I'm voting for Shelley Berkeley. I'm voting for Arthur Lampett Jr. For Lieutenant Governor, I'm voting for none of these candidates. For the Secretary of State, I'm voting for none of these candidates. For the State Treasurer, I'm voting for none of these candidates. For the State Controller, I'm voting for none of these candidates. For the Attorney General, I'm voting for none of these candidates. For the State Senate District 8, none of these candidates is not an option. I'll probably leave that one blank. State Assembly, District 13. I'll be leaving it blank. I will be voting for Don Charest. I will be voting for Michelle Schaaf. For County Assessor. For the County Clerk, I will be leaving it blank. For the County Recorder, I will be leaving it blank. For the County Treasurer, I will be leaving it blank. For Public Administrator, I will be leaving it blank. For Constable of Las Vegas Township, I will be leaving it blank. For the Justice of the Supreme Court, Seat A, I will be voting for none of these candidates. For the Justice Supreme Court, Seat E, none of these candidates. Then, I won't be voting for any except for District Court Judge, Department 29, I will be voting for Susan Scann. For District Court Judge, Department 31, I'll be voting for Joanna Kishner. For District Court Judge, Department 32, I'll be voting for Ellen Stobling, however you say that. And for Sheriff, I'll be voting for Lori Bish. The family courts, I will be leaving them blank, except for District Court Judge for Department T for the Family Division. I'm going to vote for Carl F. Piazza. And then that covers pretty much everybody we're voting for. So there you have it. And as far as all the ballots go, no, 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 no. And by tomorrow evening, I'll be sitting back watching. Now, we're going to finish up. You've got all my voting information. Now, here's what we want to talk about. It looks like November 8th will be the eviction hearing, so on and so forth. Let me bring it up. There it is. Yes, it will be right now it says on November 8th at 8 a.m., Judicial Officer Joseph S. Sicento, I guess, will be taking a look over my answer and issuing a court date. So we shall see what happens from there. But you can see they made a response, they filed it, and away we go. So we will keep you posted. But right now it looks like the next action will be taking place on November the 8th. And that's when a judicial officer will be taking a look over it, I guess. But there you have it. We're real excited. I'm sorry once again about the videos. Like I said, going through some legal things, been toning it down, so on and so forth. However, I will say this. Consultivations, if you need help, we no longer have the office, but we're still available. Email jp@mccmv or drgreenbeard@mccmv.com, and we'll be able to help you. Also, for those of you wondering, James, what was this? Hey, you were going to let us know that. I promise, as soon as the time comes, we will let you know when the next set of legal actions are taking place. Right now, I'm just trying to get through the eviction. Once we get through the eviction, get a roof over our heads, then we'll be moving forward with the warrants and so on and so forth. So I'll keep you informed as best as possible. We should be able to get the videos going each day now. Like I said, they'll be more educational than they will be commentary like they had been in the past. We're going to try to share a lot of information about hemp, you know, and different scientific things here in the future. But the main thing is get out and vote tomorrow. Let your voice be heard. Sit back and enjoy the results. Watch what happens over in Cali with Prop 19. And know that we will be seeing you again in the near future on a more consistent basis. Hang in there, guys. I promise you'll see more of us every day like it was. This was Monday, November 1st, 2010, and this was your Daily Dose.